Welcome everybody to a new series of tutorials. These tutorials are made to support a site on Facebook that is called Waldorf Doll Make-Along, and I will do a link in the description box down below so you can find it. But it is for everybody who wants to make dolls and beautiful clothes. Now let me explain somewhat more about the Make-Along site. If you found it, there will be a description, of course, of what is the site all about, and I would ask you to read that carefully. Everybody can enter, can subscribe to that site, but only those of you who want to work by my pattern, and the patterns are available on Etsy, can take part in a little contest which has a prize involved for making the underwear according to my pattern, and the next make along that will be the bonnet, etc., etc. We did make a doll in the first months of 2020, in January, February and March, and I'm continuing with that doll, that size, that is 35 centimeters or approximately 13 to 14 inches, and I will dress her up. So it's very logic to start with the underwear. Okay, if you have any questions about this explanation, then please ask down below in the comments. So let's start. You have your pattern and you will place it on your fabric. Now, what kind of fabric do you use? Do you need a very lightweight fabric? It's our doll clothes, so they are very small, and every stiff fabric is not going to do as well as somewhat more flowy fabric. Now we're going to work with either a cotton or a linen or anything else you would like to use, but not a jersey. That's because I think I want to express to everybody, or to learn everybody, how to make beautiful clothes. And I know that if you're not an experienced sewer, jersey is very, very difficult. But there's another reason too. The make-alongs that I'm doing now are going to lead to Laura from the Little House on the Prairie. And in those days, they hadn't have any jersey. So that's two reasons. But if you're not an experienced sewer, I would highly recommend to use a simple fabric that isn't too stretchy, that isn't stretchy at all. Okay, so I've cut my two pieces, and what you need also, so now you've cut your two pieces, I have one over here, and you're going to do the next. First of all, let me explain a traveler iron. I think it's ideal, because with these kind of fabrics, it is the most beautiful result if you use an iron in between to press out your seams or anything like that. As you can see, it's lying straight in front of me, making working with it so much easier. So highly recommend a little traveler iron. Okay, so you finished your edge of the leg. Now this is the waist and this is the leg. You finish it off with either a serger or with a zigzag stitch. Both is just fine. Okay, now I'm going to use a little bit of lace, and I'm going to use this kind of lace. Now, in order to use this kind of lace, as you can see, it has an already finished edge. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a little seam, press it down, just a little seam, because it isn't too wide of a lace. I mean, the width is not that much. I'm going to lay this on top of it, and I'm going to stitch it down, making sure that I overlap it with not much. With, in this case, I think it's about 3 millimeters or something like that. It's not a quarter of an inch, 1/8 of an inch, something like that. And then I will stitch it down. Now, I already prepared myself. I did that. So here it is. I've stitched my lace on top, and after that I made my pleats. And again, with a traveling iron, it's easy. And I'm going to do with the other piece as well, making sure that I make two mirrored pieces. I can't tell you how many times I did that wrong. Two mirrored pieces. This is a front side and this is a front side. You see, when I lay them on top of each other, of course I need to make pleats in this one. This is the right way. Yahoo! Okay, now I'm going to do that to this as well using my iron, because making pleats, and you're making your, make sure that you make your pleats facing downwards and ironing them in makes life so much easier. You only have to stitch by the edge and you're just fine. Then you will have two identical pieces and then we can go on. So I've finished both parts. Let me take this out. I finished both parts. As you can see with the lace. So now I'm going to join them together. And I'm going to join them on the front side, not the leg, of course, not the back side and not this side, but the front side to the crotch. I think that's the right word. This I finished off. Now I did, I must say I did a straight stitch and serged it because, well, I like a neat finish and I want to be sure that my seams are not popping open. So that's why if you use your zigzag, you have to use a straight stitch first to make sure that your seams are not popping open. Now, why did I do just one side? Because, and that was my cat, okay, because I want it to be easy and accessible for everybody. Now, if you, let me first show you, if you want to do the tunnel in a round, you can finish this up too. But to make it easier on both me and you, I am in this stage going to make the tunnel for the elastic. Now I measured my doll circumference in a belly, and just a little tip in between, if you make sure you're working on a surface that can take the heat of your traveling iron, that's even easier. I measured my doll circumference and she was 25 centimeters. Now, why did I do that? Because I, and where is it? Oh my goodness. Oh, here it is. I cut off a piece of elastic of 25 centimeters. Now, you need somewhat less because you want it to gather and to have some stretch in it. But cutting it off by 25 centimeters, you will know for sure that you have enough. I'm going to make that casing. And I'm going to do that, of course, on the back side using my iron again. Now, if you saw the pattern, you can see that we have a casing of about 1 centimeter. That is about a quarter of an inch and a little bit, 1/8 of an inch left to fold over. So what that means is it is going to fold over 1/8 of an inch. You don't have to finish this seam. Or this edge before making that casing, 1/8 of an inch, and after that it's folding over that quarter of a seam allowance or that 1 centimeter. If you have ironed that, then you can stitch right down on this edge. And for those of you who want an even more finished look, you can make a stitch line on the edge at the upper side as well. I'm going to do that, but be sure that you can take your elastic through this case. Okay? So now we have that casing for the elastic. And I top stitched it to the edge and to this edge. Now, this tool is not going through it, I think. But a darning needle of a very large size is going through, so I'm going to use that instead, because I want to prevent my elastic from popping out of my needle. I will give it just a couple of stitches just to be sure that it is not coming out. Not much to it. Oops, it's fiddly, but it works. That's enough. So, it's no problem. I'm getting this elastic through this case easily. And again, the top stitching on this edge is optional. But if you look, you will see that you have a nice result. Neat finish. And it's easy. Make sure you're not pulling your elastic completely through, but just till the edge. Now, I'm not cheating because I know I have enough elastic, because I did 25 centimeters, exactly the circumference of the doll, but I have to stretch it, so I have no problem by leaving a little bit out. Now I'm going to sew this down, making sure that I'm sewing, let me point this out, I'm sewing over here, so I have a seam that is not gathered. That's nicer to work with in the next stage. So I'm going to sew down and back again just to secure the elastic. I did a pin over here just to show you what next. Of course, you have to finish that first. Then I'm going to pull my elastic through, tuck it down. And I'm going to pull on this needle, and I'm going to make sure that I have a gathering that I think is nice to keep her pants up her butt. And I'm going to do the same thing over here. I'm just going to give it a pin. And I'm going to sew back and forth over that little piece. Okay, so now you've ended up with something like this. This I already closed because you had your elastic in your casing and you secured it on both ends. And now you can finish this seam. This is the back side of your pants. Now there's only one thing left, and that is closing the seams, the inner seams of the legs. Now in this stage you can see, and I will pin, how important it is that your pleats are completely there where they should be, because if they are not, you're not able to pin this up and get your pleats nicely together. And there is a trick for it if you think it is a bit difficult for you, and that's, I will show this in a minute. Let me close this up. Okay, so I am ready to, I can feel my pleat and lay them on top of each other. So this is ready to be sewn, and I will show that in a minute, but first let me show you a little trick. This is the pattern piece which you cut out, and you can see that here are those folds for making the pleats. Now you could draw a line. That's one of the possibilities, with some chalk. But what I do is I use just a sharp tool, and I make a line. And I do that not only in the valley, but on top too, making sure they are straight. So cutting out is even as important, of course, because that's the base for what you're going to do next. This is the valley, as I call it, because this is the lower part. Make a line. And this is the top of my pleat. And make a line over here. Now you can imagine that with chalk it is even clearer. So that way I can see that I need to fold my pleat exactly on those lines I draw with a sharp pencil. But again, if you use some chalk, it will be clearer even more. So that way, it's a little trick to make nice and even pleats. So here it is, a nice finished pants, underpants, underwear, especially made for that doll pattern that I have on Etsy. Again, it is a 35 centimeter doll. That's about between 13 and 14 inches. This is especially made for that doll. It fits great. It is neatly finished. As you can see, the pleats are all beautifully lined up. Her butt is fitting in it perfectly, because that's another line than the front to the crotch. Well, I think this is perfect. Now we're going to her chemise or shirt. I don't know what you call it. Shall we call it chemise? Okay, that will be on the next tutorial.